Oh, hey, Lane. I'm glad you're still here.
Why? What do I have to clean up this time?
Oh, nothing. Nothing. I want to talk to you more about the asphalt mixture volumetrics.
Okay, we've talked about the terms. Mm-hmm. We talked about the max gravity, bulk gravity, and the air voids.
Yeah.
Is there more?
Oh, there's a lot more. Today, I want to talk to you about the VMA and the VFA. So today I want to talk to you about the VMA and the VFA.
Okay, so I remember from the terms discussion that V is volume, but the rest?
Well, it turns out that these two don't follow the typical asphalt volumetric naming scheme.
Oh, so just like the English language, there are exceptions.
Yeah, pretty much. So VMA stands for voids in the mineral aggregate. And pretty much what that is it's the space in between the aggregate particles that can be either filled with asphalt or air.
Sounds hard to measure.
Well, it's not a direct measurement. So actually, we're going to use other things that we can measure, and we're going to calculate it. So we're going to use the GMB, the GSB, and the PS.
I'm familiar with the bulk gravity of the mixture, but GSB, that's the specific gravity of the stone bulk.
Right, right. And then the PS is the percentage of stone.
Not sure I've heard that one before.
Well, it's not that common, but really, we're going to use percentages of mass. So essentially, it's the total mass of the mixture minus the air voids.
Makes sense.
So for the calculation, VMA is 100 minus the bulk specific gravity of the mix times the percentage of binder divided by the bulk gravity of the aggregate.
So that's GMB, PS, and GSB.
Yep, and I should note that some agencies use the effective specific gravity of the stone, but we're going to use the bulk, which is more common.
Now, what kind of number should we see with the VMA?
Oh, good question, Lane. So it depends on the maximum aggregate size in the mixture. But for surface mixes, we typically see about a 15 to 16. And for base mixes, it'll be a bit lower. And really what it's telling us is how thick the film coating of asphalt is on the aggregate. And if that gets too low, then we have a less durable mix.
All right.
So let's move on to the VFA. So VFA stands for voids filled with asphalt.
Isn't that all the voids?
No, remember, we need the air voids, plus there are little spaces inside the aggregate itself that the binder can't even flow into.
Okay, this one has to be hard to measure too.
Well, again, this one is not a direct measurement, it's a calculation. So essentially, we're going to take the VMA, subtract off the air voids, divide that again by the VMA, and multiply it all by 100.
Well, that's not too hard to calculate, but what does it tell us?
So this one tells us how many of those voids that are around those aggregate particles are actually filled with asphalt. And again, it leads to a more durable mix.
So what do we typically see with the VFA mix?
Another good question. So again, it depends on the aggregate size in the mixture, but really about 65 to 80 is where we are.
Cool.
So now that we understand VMA and VFA, let's take these measurements that we gathered yesterday and practice the calculations.
Okay, but can we do it tomorrow? I was just headed out.
Yeah, I guess.